following feature has been rated PG by the Motion Picture Association of America. Parental discretion is advised.
It's party time. Oh, it's party time. Having a party. Come on.
Live from Pacific Quay, it's another quality broadcast for the BBC.
It's the Friday before Halloween, and tonight we're going to suck your blood. Tell everybody you know it's the Ashley Story Show. Go tell everybody you know it's the Ashley Story Show. Come for the music and stay for the sparkling with silent birthdays. All right, let's get on with it. Go tell everybody you know it's the Ashley Story Show.
I'm Ashley Story, you're listening to BBC Radio Scotland live from Pacific Quay, joined as always by sidekick Silent Paul. Hello Silent Paul, how are you this week?
I'm all right.
We're talking fears, we're talking spooky stories, we want to hear your true paranormal experiences. Get in touch via text 80295 if you want your true paranormal experience read out. We're also talking about irrational fears. Paul, do you have any irrational fears?
I only have the rational fears. I am the Dana Scully in this relationship.
I mean, it makes me sad because I want to be Dana Scully, but you're right, I'm the Fox Mulder.
Oh, no, 100% you are the Fox Mulder.
Just
in this
wandering
one where
into the
you
mist.
Will believe anything and everything. Like, there will be 10 spectres in this building that has just been invented by Ashley.
In my head.
Oh, what was that noise?
100%. I've got the temperament of a scared chihuahua and the imagination of a four-year-old. So I'm living my best life. I'm definitely the Fox Mulder. Do you believe in aliens?
No.
How, though?
We've had this conversation. I don't believe in them. Because
disclosures happened, friend. It's those, already out
and
there.
And yet people like Professor Brian Cox came out and said none of it was proven.
Well, I didn't like him in Succession.
Have they ever done anything together?
It
feels like they should have.
It feels like Brian Cox and Brian Cox should get together and have a Cox fight.
Cox on Cox.
It'd be great. I think it'd be fantastic. I don't know why they've not done something together. Anyway, irrational fears.
And do you know what? There's an easy title in there.
Oh, yes, there's a million easy titles, yeah. Paul. But come on, let's not get complaints. What are you? Irrational. Any? What are your rational fears?
Rational fears? Oh, I just feel like failure. Just the constant fear of failure.
That's really sad.
Yeah.
Because you need to fail.
No, like, you don't.
Yeah, wait, no, you do. Everybody needs to fail. It's part of life. You have to fail so that
you will
be inspirational.
But you don't need to.
You do. People who haven't failed enough are unbearable. Have you ever met somebody who's just succeeded at everything? Awful human beings. They're the worst. You know it's true. You know I'm 100% right.
Well, right. We know some of your irrational fears. If you're a long-term listener to the show, you will know.
I like that you use term because it's like a prison sentence.
Yes. Long-term listener to the show, you'll have heard dolls, paintings.
Yeah, yes. Don't like dolls. Don't
certain want
get,
paintings.
Don't want to get turned into a doll.
You don't want to get sucked into a painting.
Do not want to get sucked into a painting like The Beginning of Witches. Terrifying film. Should never have been shown to children. Wandering black holes. Asteroids.
Time travellers.
Oh, time travellers. I don't like the idea of time travellers. I don't like the idea that in the future I'm going to time travel and mess up my own life, Paul. That's what really frightens me.
We've spoken about this before. That didn't happen.
You don't know that.
It didn't happen.
You don't know that.
Spooky toy museum ghosts. As you were speaking to the ladies on introducing, there is rational explanations for everything.
Do you remember in The X-Files, they kept that shtick going where Dana Scully was like, there must be a rational explanation. And there's literally an alien running past her when alien heat.
No, the best was,
and she's like, no.
Her child was literally born of alien.
She's like, nah, I'm still a sceptic.
The child's got psychic powers and things are floating about and she's like,
she's sitting on Facebook going, genuinely asking, but are aliens real? Just a question. Get in touch via text 80295. Let us know your irrational fears and let us know your true paranormal stories. You can also email us. What's the email, Paul?
It's ashleystoryshow@bbc.co.uk.
And you can WhatsApp us. What's the WhatsApp?
0808 592 95 00.
Do it again. Don't ruin it in the middle.
0808 592 95 00.
Uh-oh. We've got loads of songs coming up. We've got your stories. I've got some genuinely creepy tales to tell you. But first of all, let's set the mood. Let's get it, Spook.
Spooky.
You don't want your Springfield to be dusty. That would freak my mum out.
Like that feels like a haunted western town.
Yeah, yeah. You don't come around here, this is spooky Springfield. I don't know what that voice was, but it all came out one side of my mouth. It was Holly Hunt. I know exactly who I was trying to do.
That was a Holly Hunter.
That's it, Holly Hunter.
You're conflating Hunt. Helen Hunt,
yes.
With Holly Hunter.
But you know, she does that voice. She's like, oh, thank you for this Oscar for me playing the piano. Remember? That's a banging impersonation of that woman. Don't know why I've never done that before. Quickly, I need to tape into my spotlight and put in my skills that I do Holly Hunter impersonation. We've got some spooky stories, but people have been getting in touch and telling us their irrational fears. Dr. D says, a fried egg and beans on the same plate.
Oh, yeah, they can't touch. They're okay to be on the same plate, but they must not touch.
That's why I don't eat fried egg. Like, a scrambled egg can touch beans. A fried egg cannot.
It can't.
So you just go scramble, because it keeps you safe. Mm-hmm. Jen says, spiders, cancel that. It's perfectly rational to be scared of those sneaky, horrendous, predatory monsters. Are spiders bad? In Australia, they're bad.
Yeah, in other places in the world, then yes. But here, not so much.
And see, the thing is, Australians love to tell foreigners lies when they go there. So you turn up and they're like, oh, you better watch out for the drop bear. And you're like, oh my goodness, what's that? And like, it's a bear that falls out the sky and it'll kill you. And then you find out that's a joke. But then they're like, yeah, but you do have to watch out. You do have to watch out for the black widows. And I'm like, oh, very funny with the drop bears. Okay, they fall out the tree and they destroy you. And I'm like, you've said that already.
I've seen too many videos online of spiders basically the size of your face just hanging about in corners of rooms.
I was in Adelaide when there was a literal plague of like crickets. It was when you walk down the street, it was locusts and crickets.
Yeah.
When you walk down the street, it was just you couldn't see pavement because it was just thick with locusts, and every step
was a
crunch, and it was terrifying. Do you know what the worst part of that was? I was very young, and I still snogged a guy stoning and all the cockroaches. And every time I moved my feet, all I could hear was.
Nothing will stop a horny teenager.
Nothing whatsoever. He was in the Territorial Army. That's hot. Anyhow.
Is it hot to be in the real army, or is it just the territorial one that you like?
I don't know. Do you know what? I think it's like, I like the part-time nature of the Territorial Army.
Yeah.
He's not going to be away for years on end.
Mm-hmm. You're an action man, but you're still...
But you've still got a job in a bank.
You're 9 to 5.
Yes, yeah. Exactly. Tater says, mirrors and volcanoes is an irrational fear.
Volcanoes, not so much, because, I mean, they will do you damage if they go off.
Mm-hmm.
But mirrors... Mm.
Had a run of nightmares about mirrors as a teenager. Like seeing someone behind me, seeing somebody else's face, etc. Volcanoes is because Mount Etna blew up a week after my family holiday in Sicily when I was 4.
That's fair enough.
That's a rational fear. Mirrors, I get. Mirrors are terrifying because the notion. Also, are you afraid of the dark?
No.
Did a lot of. I wasn't asking.
I thought you were asking me. No. Right.
No, there was no question mark. It was a statement.
You're speaking about the children's show.
The children's show, Are You Afraid of the Dark, had an episode with a girl who was trapped in a mirror, and then another person got sucked in the mirror, and it scared me. It was frightening.
But then how many other scary films have you seen that have things with inanimate objects that you then don't get an irrational fear about.
Paul, I saw The Happy Toaster when I was like 3 and was terrified of my toaster for about a year. Because the idea that I was setting it on fire on the inside every time I made toast, I was like, it must hate me. I'm hurting it. No, mirrors are like huge in urban legends. Bloody Mary, you do it in front of a mirror. Candyman, you do it in front of a mirror. So mirrors are imbued with a lot
I think that's just because mirrors were generally likely to be found in every single house.
And I think it's also
so
because...
it's a good storytelling prop.
In the olden days, the mirror was the closest thing you had to a telly.
I can't confirm the sources for that. Let's just say that that's Ashley's opinion and is not verified by any historian on the planet.
Mary Beard, get in touch. Let me know I'm right. I would love... I think I'm right. Get in touch via text 80295. Do you think I'm right? Also, tell us your irrational fears. Tell us your true paranormal stories. We want to hear your true ghost stories. One of my favourite ghost stories is ghost.
Yeah, and I think we if you also want to get in touch,
it's 80295, but tell us the email and tell us the WhatsApp, yeah, and then we'll talk
Ashley
about ghost.
Ashley Story Show at bbc.co.uk, mm-hmm, or 0805 92 95 00.
Uh-oh.
We want to also talk about scary movies and television shows.
Right.
Which ones were scary and which ones were most definitely not scary?
Are You Afraid of the Dark was terrifying. The Twilight Zone was terrifying. Anything that makes me think, I don't find ghosties or jump scares that scary. Like, I don't find stuff like that frightening. Paranormal Activity, none of that. See stuff that's like, and then it turned out that was his own hand. That kind
that,
of stuff,
that gets you.
That gets me.
Oh, you're in the whole world. You're the last man, the only man on earth. You hate everyone, so it's good. But oh no, you drop your glasses and you can't read any books. Oh,
there's a gremlin on the wing. Not as frightening, but still a laugh. Gremlins frightened me so much.
Gremlins is a scary movie. The gremlins are like horrific.
Gremlins are terrifying, but also in what world? Because that wouldn't have happened nowadays. In what world do you have a creature that has very specific handling rules? That if you get it wet, if you feed it at the wrong time, if any of this happens...
But how does it know time zones?
It's going to spawn an end-of-the-world creature that's going to go insane. Why would you give that to a teenager? He didn't.
Well, the dad didn't know.
He didn't know. Okay.
The dad didn't know. The dad saw it, says, I want to buy that. The Chinese guy said, no.
You can't have it.
And he stole it.
I didn't know he stole it.
Gave it to his son.
He shouldn't have had it lying out in the shop anyway. He just shouldn't have. That's too tempting.
It was his pet.
What's he doing keeping a thing like that as a pet? That's dangerous. That's like Tiger King level of recklessness.
It still deserves to live.
Even if it spawns evil gremlins.
But he's nice.
So, can I ask, because you seem to be, as your gremlin's explaining to me, is the...
He's
gone full leg spread.
Let me tell you about gremlins.
In the gremlins, right? What's the wee thing called?
Mowgli.
Right. That's a good gremlin.
It's not a gremlin. It's a Mowgli. That's just that's what it's. It is a Mowgli.
Right. And so a Mowgli is a creature that, if it gets wet or eats after a certain time, gives birth to an army of the damned.
Yeah.
That's so weird. No, I'm sorry. I know that this is controversial take, hot take. Things shouldn't be about.
What did you want me to do? Just like.
I don't want to say what I wanted him to do, but that's like keeping an ancient book that's got smallpox in it. Just put it in a fire.
No, but the box isn't a sentient being. You could just burn the book. Well, you probably shouldn't, because that might spread it through the smoke. But you should just get, like, dispose of the book. But how are you meant to dispose of the sentient being, which...
Which, if it gets wet or eats after midnight, will cause an army of the damned. That will destroy the world.
We all have flaws.
I mean, I know in Gremlins 2, the gremlins get personalities, and you've got fun gremlins.
Yeah, some of
like
them
Barbies.
Just kiss you now.
You've got like happy gremlin, businessman gremlin, mm-hmm, electro dance gremlin.
Spider one was quite scary though.
Yeah, the sexy lady gremlin.
Yeah.
She was cool. She was a feminist icon. Anyway, we were meant to talk about ghosts and we started talking about gremlins.
We wanted to talk about scary movies.
But the film Ghost, not scary.
Not scary.